questions from the audience? Would you stand and state your name, please?
I'm Flint Linson. I live at 416 South 4th Street, Bristol, Missouri. I was wondering, like, why don't you know the name of the business that might be using the lawn money to donate homes?
I do know the name of the company. But I'm not disclosing the name of the company at this point. It would be premature to do that. We still are operating under conditions of confidentiality with the company at this point. So I do know clearly, obviously I do know the name of the company. Does that answer your question?
I just don't understand, like, I'm not a business setting.
Well, that's okay. That's what a public hearing is for.
I'm not sure, like, what their advantage is by doing that or by disclosing their own name until things are approved. And, like, what's their advantage of doing that?
Well, this is still what would be called a competitive project. And we are competing with, as we are told, another state and another community. And we would prefer not to talk about the company wants their name kept quiet at this point. And we prefer not to disclose the name of the company or the state proposal of incentives for competitive purposes.
Other questions? Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Public hearing is closed. We now come to the time in our meeting for citizen participation. If there's any citizens wishing to speak, we have 5 minutes to talk about anything we want to talk about.
That's not on the agenda.
That's not on the agenda, sorry.
I'm Claire Reynolds. I live in Ryle Hall, 426 South Mullenix Street, or 1215 South Mullenix Street, Kirksville, Missouri. I'm speaking today through my debate communications class. I wanted to discuss the past proposal to increase Kirksville's sales tax. As you know, it did not pass well in the election. I researched the tax specifically looking at the website information presented by City Council, and I feel that the tax is a very good idea. I believe the people who risk their lives on a daily basis to help and save our lives definitely deserve a salary increase and better training methods. It is understanding why the tax did not pass. Our economy is in a very uncertain situation, and the idea of increasing the sales tax is scary to most people. But I feel with the right target audience and with the right PR, it will be possible to pass such a tax in the future. I think the City Council would greatly benefit from targeting Truman students. We make up almost a third of the population at least 9 months out of the year, and many of us stay throughout the summer. We spend countless time and money at the local businesses, especially the Hy-Vee and Walmart, which make us leading contributors to the Kirksville economy. We are also receivers of the services offered by the local fire and police departments. Because of our influence in the community, we'd be very much affected by such a sales tax increase. I was a member of Truman State's College Democrats organization this past fall semester, and we worked very hard to register Truman students of all political parties to vote in Adair County. I personally worked multiple shifts to get fellow students signed up. We were registering people up to the last possible minute, and by the end we had registered over 1,000 Truman students. This means that over 1,000 students, not including ones that have already been registered in previous years, have the ability to vote in the local elections. According to the KTVO website, the tax lost in a vote of 1,266 to 615 votes. Truman students could have easily made up the difference. In reality, only 10 Truman students voted in this past local election on April 7th. By targeting Truman's campus and making the students more aware of what the City Council is doing, the city of Kirksville could become a much stronger community. A sales tax increase would definitely affect us, but we are a functioning part of this community and we use the services that would benefit from such a tax. It would benefit City Council to possibly come to speak on campus some night before such an election just to make us very aware of what you are trying to accomplish and how we can help. Also, information could be posted on our TrueView site, which is our email database, and I know many students check it religiously, including myself, therefore making us more aware. Finally, it would be helpful to possibly print off flyers and brochures to place around campus. Truman students can be made into very strong resources for the community, which I think would be good for everyone involved. I urge City Council to use us in the future as a reliable resource to ensure certain issues are passed successfully. Thank you.
Are there others wishing to speak? Okay, we'll go on to, we don't have any unfinished business, and so we shall go on to action presentation.
A resolution of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, stating the intent to seek funding through the Community Development Block Grant Program and authorizing the mayor to pursue activities in an attempt to secure funding.
Make a motion.
Thank you.
Second.
Any discussion? Questions? Oh, Cherie.
The city is proposing to obtain CDBG funds on behalf of the Kirksville Downtown Improvement Committee for the employment of an executive director. Due to projected progress for downtown Kirksville, the Dream Initiative sponsor PJV Urban Consulting recommended the KDIC employ an executive director. However, due to funding constraints, the KDIC is unable to employ and house a full-time or part-time employee. The city was directed to submit a CDBG application for $100,000. If awarded, the KDIC will employ an executive director for $50,000 the first year and $50,000 the second year. The KDIC and the executive director will be required to provide continued salary after the second year. And a public hearing is required as part of the application process. And a fiscal impact, there will be no city monies expended for this project. The city proposes to contribute $2,500 in kind labor, and total CDBG funds requested is $100,000.
Any questions?
I guess I have some questions. This is the KDIC, will an executive director will be required to provide continued salary up to second year, so they themselves will have to look for further funding?
Yes, whether it's through fundraising capabilities or a community improvement district or other tools.
Membership fees.
Membership fees.
And is it possible that that position would not be renewed or that it could go on if they couldn't find the funding then?
Of course, it's possible. However, they are supposed to come up with a plan while submitting the application for continued salary.
And then with the, so is it the KDIC that will come up with like the job description and qualifications? Will the city have any, I guess, will they help to hire or use some of the things available, or will that all be KDIC that will do the hiring?
The city has proposed that we will assist in the search for a KDIC executive director, but ultimately it will fall on the KDIC to choose, and of course the city will assist. Like right now, next week, if this is approved, I will be meeting with the KDIC Executive Director Committee, and we will discuss job description and what their plans and their hopes are for Executive Director, and the plans that they hope to continue to continue the salary down the road. This is really just seed money that we are, I wouldn't say desperate, but we're in great need of.
And the $2,500 from the city, that's just a ballpark figure because we're going to put more money into that. That's in kind. Pat Meredith is our HR manager. She would be the one who would do the postings and screen the applications under the guidance of the KDIC. Cherie's already come up with the job description, but the KDIC needs to sign off on it. And so ultimately what we want is to not be the staff when the KDIC needs some help. We want them to have their own staff person that we would work with ultimately.
Any other questions? Do you have any questions for your attendees? Are we ready to vote? All those in favor?